Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
First, I want to tell you that I'm a Muslim. I believe in everything written in the Book of Allah and Al-Quran, and in everything He said. But unfortunately, I find difficulty to convince myself with the Farida of Hijab. Do you have any advice concerning this? I wish that you could assist me and many of my friends.
Okay.
Thank you.
Jazakallah khair for your honesty. May Allah reward you for your honesty. And this is the first step to solve any problem, is to be honest, to admit I have a problem, to admit I have a difficulty. If a person doesn't even admit they have a difficulty, they will never be able to solve the problem. Let me remind myself and you that to commit a sin is one thing, but to justify a sin is much worse. To commit a sin is not good, it's bad. But to justify a sin is a million times worse. If I'm committing a sin, suppose, a'udhu billah, suppose somebody is smoking or drinking, and he says, oh, I know I'm a sinner, may Allah forgive me. This is not good, at least though he's being honest with Allah. And when you're honest with Allah, there is hope for forgiveness. When you're honest with Allah, at least there's a chance of repentance. The Prophet ﷺ said, feeling guilty for a sin is the essence of repentance. Anadamu tawbah. Feeling guilty means you know you're committing a sin. You know you're committing a sin. This is the essence or the first step to repent from that sin. So make sure if you are committing a sin, that you don't justify that sin. Because justifying the sin is something that is very, very dangerous. Extremely dangerous. And that really lowers that rank that we have with Allah infinitely. Secondly, you ask, I have difficulty about the fariḍah of hijab. I remind you that the concept of hijab is a concept that is found very explicitly in the book of Allah Jalla Jalaluhu, and very explicitly in the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah says in the Quran that let the believing women, وَلْيَضْرِبْنَ بِخُمُرِهِنَّ عَلَى جُيُوبِهِنَّ. Allah says in the Quran that let the believing women draw their khumur over their juyub. And khumur is the plural of khimar. And khimar is the Arabic word for that which covers your head. In English we call it a headscarf. So Allah is saying, let believing women draw their headscarves over their juyub. And juyub is their chest area. So Allah is saying, take your headscarf and make sure that you cover even your chest with the headscarf. This is very explicit in the Quran. There's no ambiguity here. Many people now are saying, where does the Quran say we have to do hijab? These people are people who have never read the Quran. It's right there in front of them, black and white. It's right there. Allah says, let believing women put their headscarves and cover their necks with it. Why is this? Because some women, listen to this, some women in the days of Jahiliyyah, they would cover their hair, but they would take their headscarf and throw it behind their back, and they would expose the upper chest. They would expose the upper chest. You know how the dresses are in our times, the low blouses that are common in the Western attire. In front of other women, that is something else. But in front of men, no woman can wear something like this. So Allah is saying, even if you wear a headscarf, make sure you cover the front part of your body as well. Don't just take a headscarf and throw it behind you. Take the headscarf and put it in front of you. So the Quran is very clear. And realize, my dear sisters, that this concept of modesty is something that Allah is doing not just for our protection, but primarily for yours. Allah says in the Quran that let believing women wear their coverings and garments. Why? ذَلِكَ أَدْنَى أَنْ يُعْرَفْنَ فَلَا يُؤْذَيْنَ. That is better for them. Allah is saying, for you to wear your scarf, for you to wear your covering, it is better for you. Allah is saying. Why? So that they will be recognized and not taunted, not humiliated, not become the object of teasing and of evil things. فَلَا يُؤْذَيْنَ. So my dear sister, realize that this protection that Allah wants from you, it is to protect you, not only to protect the rest of society, but to protect you. Also realize that our Prophet ﷺ, Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam praised modest women, and he praised women who guard their chastity and who guard their beauty that Allah has given to them. And he also was not happy. In fact, in some ahadith, he cursed those women who flaunt their beauty. In one hadith, he said, those women who do so, they will not smell the fragrance of paradise. In another hadith, he said, these women who flaunt their beauty are of the signs of the day of judgment. This is of the signs of the end of times, that women will lose modesty. And in another, all of these hadith, basically, they tell us the positive of covering, the positive of being modest, and the negative of being immodest. My dear sister in Islam, let me remind you of a blessing that all of you here take for granted. It is a blessing of living in a Muslim land and a Muslim country. I come from America, that's where I live, that's where my home is, that's where my family, everybody is there. For a sister to wear hijab in America, it's not easy, especially post 9/11. I know, we know this as Muslims living there. My own wife has been threatened, ridiculed, people mock her, people look at her and stare. There's something strange, they'll give sarcastic comments. Sometimes even if I'm with her, they might just give an evil remark or something like this. It's not easy practicing Islam in Western lands. And yet, we find that alhamdulillah, hundreds and thousands of Muslim men and Muslim women are rediscovering Islam in the West. You go to Islamic conferences as large as these, nay, even larger than this. And you find, mashallah, brothers upon the sunnah, sisters are wearing hijab. They are doing so despite the problems living in the West. My dear sister, Allah has blessed you to live in the East. Allah has blessed you to be amongst Muslims. No one will make fun of you if you wear a scarf. No one will ridicule you. No one will give you threats. No one will think anything strange of you. This is a Muslim society. You're living amongst Muslims. You hear the adhan. You're mixing with people who believe in Allah and His Messenger. What is possibly preventing you from this level of excellence? What is there preventing you from coming closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Ya ayyuha al-insanu ma gharraka bi rabbika al-kareem. Why are you deceived? Something so simple, so straightforward, living in a society of people who are believers in Allah and His Messenger. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the strength and the courage, and He gives all of us the strength and the courage and the iman to live like Muslims, to act like Muslims, to behave like Muslims. This is only by doing this, and only by being proud to be Muslim, will the pride that Islam deserves return. My dear sister, I ask you a blunt question. If you are embarrassed about being a Muslim, if I'm embarrassed about being a Muslim, then is it any confusion? Is it any wonder that Islam has become something to be embarrassed about? The day that you are proud to be a Muslimah and I am proud to be a Muslim, that is the day that Islam itself shall regain its pride. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who bring that pride back. Wa jazakumullahu khayran. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.